91.2 FM.
There comes a time when we hit a certain call, when the world must come together as one. There are people dying.
Oh, when it's time to lend a hand to life,
the greatest gift of all.
We can't go on pretending day by day
that someone somehow will soon make a change.
Nadie ingin donhar, eksena, katakan off.
We are all a part of God's great big family, and it's true, you know, love is what we need.
We are.
All right. Good afternoon, our wonderful listeners. This is Bolong Dala FM 91.2. And today on the program, you have Suleiman Lecturer Daba together with Binta Toure. You are reminded that this is the fourth edition of the weekly Youth Hour that will be coming on your way every Saturday from the hour of 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. And the importance of this particular program cannot, of course, be overemphasized. So today, being the first of its kind, and of course the first day or the first edition of the program, we are going to introduce the program, the importance of the program, and why the management of this noble radio station deem it befitting to include this program or this particular youth hour in their program guide. So it's going to be a discussion, and as we move deep into the program, we will open telephone line as well as text message to make sure that the program is lively and everyone's contribution is, of course, noted. So with me in the studio is my co-host, a giant lady, and I will allow her to introduce herself formally, then we can pick it from there.
Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Suleiman Dabo. Like he said, my name is Binta L.Y. Toure. We'll be hosting this program together. That is the Youth Hour. The Youth Hour will come on every Saturday from 2 to 3 o'clock on 91.2 FM, that is Bulundala FM, and we'll be your host every Saturday. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much, Binta. I call her a giant lady, but I mean, she's trying to denounce that. But as we move deep into the program and in our subsequent editions, you will agree with me that Binta is a giant lady. And of course, I mean, a giant when it comes to youth work. So basically, Binta, here we are today marking the first edition of this noble program. I think this program is important.
Indeed, yes, it's important because young people are being consist of 65% of the Gambia's population.
Mm-hmm.
Having an hour on the radio talking about issues that are affecting us, mm-hmm, especially our development, is very crucial. And I think this is a noble initiative.
Mm-hmm.
And I think every young person should sit and listen to this program because it's going to be interactive, educative,
mm-hmm,
and it's also going to be, sometimes it's going to be a way to build your careers.
Mm-hmm.
So it's very important for you people to sit down and listen to this program that will come your way on Bulundala FM every Saturday from 2 to 3 o'clock, which is going to be a very, very educative program because Suleiman is one of a kind when it comes to youth work. It's my first time working with him, but according to his biography, I think Suleiman is one of a kind, and we will not lose anything by listening to his programs on the radio.
All right. Thank you very much, Binda. Although I don't believe that I deserve all that you've said, and I've equally been following you. Thanks to Allah, this is the first time we're working together, and we hope to actually do our little best in making sure that issues related to young people are actually aired for the wider audience out there, which is our listeners, to better understand the youth sector. So this program, like Binda said, is of course very important. The importance cannot be overemphasized. We can keep on talking about listing its importance from here till the program elapses, and we cannot exhaust. Like she said, young people of the Gambia consist of about 65% of the population. That makes us important, and of course that makes us necessary when it comes to the development of this country. We cannot be exempted. So creating a platform where of course this important sector of our population will come and discuss, share challenges, and talk about success stories as well as prospects, I think is quite important, Binda. So we definitely hoping to get your participation as our listeners, and together we can definitely change the youth sector as well as inform many listeners about the relevant or the current opportunities that also exist within the sector, because obviously we have challenges, but definitely there are opportunities for young people in the Gambia. But how many people know about this? Only few actually know about this. So this program is specifically designed to at least help those people who have not been accessing information regarding the opportunities for young people to basically have an idea or at least an opportunity to get access to those information. So we'll be here every week from the hour of 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. to be sharing and discussing about some of those challenges and opportunities as well as prospects in the youth sector. So Binda, we cannot exhaust the importance of this youth program.
Absolutely.
So if there is anything that you want to say, Anton?
Yeah, I like you just said, I want to add on something, some few things on what you said. If you see, there are a lot of opportunities for young people, but the issue here is awareness raising is lacking.
Yeah, exactly.
But I think this platform is going to create that awareness raising that young people need to know, to know about the opportunities available, the alternative opportunities in this country. Because if you can see, currently there is an increase in crime rate and all sort of things. But if you pay attention to this platform, listen, we are going to educate you and inform you about those opportunities available that young people can tap in order to make their life better for them and to help them earn a decent living.
Yeah, exactly like you said, Binda. That was quite precise and in fact straight to the point. So through this program, we hope that young people will get access to information, because that is crucial and that is important to us. That is very important to this radio station as an institution. So we want to help young people to access information regarding some of these opportunities. There are a lot and lot of opportunities in the youth sector, although there are challenges.
Absolutely.
And as we get deep into the program, you will hear from youth leaders and several stakeholders who will be discussing about some of these challenges and possible opportunities, and as well as the prospect of you the youth sector in the Gambia. So we would like to actually share some contacts, because like I said, this is the first program, the first edition of the program, and it will be important that we engage each other. We are just moderators, and you are very important when it comes to this program. Listeners are very important. So we will share the contacts. You can send in your text messages as well as call in order for us to share our views for the purpose of which the authorities of this FM include this noble program in their program guide, which is the Youth Hour. So the attainment of the objectives of this program cannot be fully attained or achieved when our listeners are not actually with us. And we believe this program is important. So we're hoping to actually get more participation from the listeners. So Binda will get us through the contacts that we will be getting in touch in order for you to participate, whether it's today or in our subsequent editions. So Binda, you can share the contacts.
Like Suleiman was likely saying, this program is very, very important, especially from this radio, because one thing we the young people are lacking is information. And when you lack information, it's like you I don't know how to say it. If you don't have information, if you are not informed, you cannot act on anything. So we would like to inform you, give you, guide you through this platform, so at least to see how we can attain the best from us. And if you see, this program is being introduced on this radio because I think young people, we constitute 65% of the population, and that percent of the population cannot be neglected. So that is why we are here. We are just here to moderate this hour because it's our first hour. We want to interact with the listeners so to know their own perspective about young people and the issues affecting young people in the Gambia. So the numbers to call to send in your text messages are 784-1456-3296-069.
All right, you've all heard what Binda said. The numbers are 784-1456-784-1456-784-1456. And those with user line, you can call 329-6069. All right, you can send in your SMSs and your calls through these numbers. Together we can share our views, discuss on the importance of this program as a start, because like we said, this is the first edition of the program. And normally, starting everything involves a bit of introduction and trying to engage actually those relevant stakeholders, because we know our listeners are our major stakeholders when it comes to this program, because it is from our listeners that we are going to get people that we will subsequently be hosting in this program. So it is in the same from the same listeners that young people or the youthful sector of this country reside. So the listeners are very important when it comes to this program. We are just moderating, you know, for you to actually join us in trying to at least share our views together. So thank you very much, Binda, on that. So Binda, can you elaborate a little bit about how this program will be conducted weekly? Because we know it is 1 hour program, from the hours of from the hour of 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. So the duration is not that much long, but at least it's better for a comprehensive discussion to be tabled out. So maybe you should talk about how we intend at the level of the radio on how we want to conduct this particular program.
Okay, Suleiman, I think the way we want to do it is that because we are not masters in this field. We take our listeners to be our key stakeholders in this. So sometimes we'll be inviting hosts of people ranging from the youth sector, the government, and sometimes from UN bodies, because we see all of them, their contribution toward the development of young people in the Gambia cannot be neglected. So having them on this platform, talking to young people about what they have for us and what they are doing for the young people, it's very important and key to our program and to our agendas.
Yes, thank you, Binda. Like Binda said, we'll be getting whole lot of people in this program. We subsequent programs will involve hosting a lot of people from different walks of life, but working towards the improvement of young people. So we know of youth organizations in the Gambia that are obviously doing tremendously well. So we'll be hosting representatives from those youth organizations. It could be their communication officers, their leaders, you know, and in fact, representatives from the government, because we know you cannot talk about issues related to young people without talking about the government. So we'll be hosting people from the government and other civil society organizations that are working towards the well-being of young people in this country. So equally, we know of activists. There are activists in this country who are unarguably doing their quota towards the development of this country. So we'll be hosting a wide range of people working towards the development of young people. And we are not forgetting about UN bodies, because like we know of UN bodies that are actually here specifically for the well-being of young people. They want to see youth of this country excel in their individual endeavors. But like we said, access to information has always been a concern. It has always been a problem. So how do we make sure that young people of this country access the information that they need to access skills, the available skills that are in the youth sector, which are strength for them, that they can actually, I mean, tap in order for them to change their lives and livelihood? Only if you access this information. So that is why it is important for the authorities and the management of this radio to come up with this program, which is the Youth Hour, to share their views, to enable people to share their views, most especially listeners, to enable them to equally access information. So Binda, mm-hmm. we'll take a little bit turn, because we know despite the numerous achievements, successes in the youth sector, mm-hmm. I mean, there are challenges
yeah.
in the youth sector. And one of those challenges, like I said, could be, in fact, access to information.
Yeah.
Many young people are not accessing information.
Yeah.
You know, what are some of the challenges that young people are facing in this country? You know?
Suleiman, like I said, in any positive case, you see there is a negative aspect
of
it.
Indeed.
And I believe young people in the Gambia are really trying.
Mm-hmm.
From their side, they are trying. It's just what the issue here is. They just need a little tap on their back to do more than what they are doing. I can say to do better than where they are.
Mm-hmm.
There are a lot of challenges that are affecting young people,
mm-hmm.
ranging from accessing information,
mm-hmm.
Irregular migration. Most especially, migration is an issue.
That's important. Irregular migration as an aspect, in fact, is very important and very crucial, because like of recent, we've seen large chunk of young Gambian youth involving themselves in this perilous journey to Europe, popularly known as back way.
Yeah.
So that is a concern. There are a lot of challenges that young people are confronted with.
And what is happening now is that many young people don't have skills. They will graduate, they will go to school up to grade 12, and
mm-hmm.
after grade 12 they have nothing to do.
Mm-hmm.
So I believe when we have this program, bringing people who are well versed in the areas of youth work,
mm-hmm.
and that can provide them and people that can provide them information,
mm-hmm.
to access those opportunities in
mm-hmm.
the Gambia, I think it's very important. And in that, we can address the challenges that we are facing in the Gambia in the youth sector.
That's important, Binda. You talked about tapping young people of this country on their back, but I think you've just tapped me on my back when you just brought the issue of young people getting schooled after completion of grade 12 and just dropping out. And they will not be skilled, they will just be there like that without involving themselves in any vocational training or so forth. So that's why we say one of the key importance of this program is making sure that linking those young people who are sitting and not doing anything to the available opportunities that are there, because there are a lot of vocational training centers in this country. that are offering opportunities for young people of such category mm-hmm. to get themselves skilled and benefit themselves tomorrow, because it's important, you know.
I think even as of me, that is what I do most of the time, because okay. What happens is I think my job is so much close to that. So what I do normally is that if I see a lot of young people or mm-hmm. any young people that is not doing anything, mm-hmm. I make sure I try to advise you mm-hmm. to link you to opportunities that where you can go and at least you can mm-hmm. access something where it's not only going to be, it's not benefiting me, but you, the person that is not doing anything, you will benefit from it. Mm-hmm. So even yesterday, as I was sitting down, I saw a young, when I was going to work, I saw a young person sitting okay. outside. So I asked, what are you doing after grade 12? Mm-hmm. Because he graduated since, mm-hmm. so he's not doing anything. So I passed him, I asked him, what are you doing? He said nothing. I said, okay, you can come to my office. Then I have something for you. Mm-hmm. When he came, I gave him a form to fill. Then he said that. I said, let's just hope for the best that mm-hmm. from here you can access the school to start something new with your life.
So that's
I think young people, we are really trying. It's mm-hmm. just that what what we are doing is not being acknowledged, but I think young people in the Gambia are really trying their best, and we cannot neglect the fact that they are really doing the best for
obviously,
themselves.
Obviously. Young people of the Gambia are undoubtedly doing their best, and they are champions when it comes to the development of this country. And I don't think there'll be anyone who cannot acknowledge that. Well, if you don't acknowledge it, it means you just don't acknowledge what you're supposed to acknowledge.
Yeah.
Yes.
I can see, even if by looking at the from the area, the aspect, the perspective of irregular migration in mm-hmm. the Gambia, mm-hmm. if you see people are migrating in the Gambia, most especially the young population is migrating. Mm-hmm. It's because I can see. Because there are a lot of push factors that are pushing us from our country. Mm-hmm. Because even when you are a skillful person, mm-hmm. and you are in your country, and especially at their young age, people mm-hmm. are not patronizing you, mm-hmm. and they are not seeing your effort.
Yeah.
They try to neglect you. They mm-hmm. don't even see the impact you are creating in the society. Mm-hmm. I think that is one reason that a lot of people are migrating from the Gambia to other countries in the world.
Yeah.
So I think having such a platform to discuss about the challenges the young people are facing in the Gambia, mm-hmm. and discuss most especially because these are realities that we are seeing. Mm-hmm. Sometimes we just neglect. We just don't want to speak about it. But mm-hmm. these are real things that are happening in our societies and in our environment. Yeah. So coming here and talking about it, I think it's going to be a very, very unique opportunity for our listeners, most especially the youth population. Mm-hmm.
So just to remind you, in case you are just joining us, you are in tune to Bolong Dala FM, 91.2, located in Brikama. So if you want to call or text, please kindly call or text through the following numbers. The official line is 7841456, 7841456, 7841456. And the chosen number is 3296069. Please kindly send in your text messages, as well as if you want to call, you call in order for you to be part of the program. And of course, you are also equally reminded that this is the fourth edition of Weekly Youth Hour that will be coming on your way every Saturday from the hour of, okay, it's like we are in a quarter.
Let's come together as one. There are people dying.
Oh, when it's time to lend a hand to life,
the greatest gift of all.
Can't go on pretending day by day.
That's
the one make a change.
We are all a part of God's great big family. And it's true, you know love is all we need.
We are.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much. We are back again. Like we said, if you want to call, you can call through 781-456. 781-456 and 329-6069. 329-6069. So those are the numbers available for one to call or send in your text messages. Like we said, you are reminded that this is Bolong Dala FM 91.2 located in Brikama. So this is the fourth edition of the weekly youth hour that will be coming on your way every Saturday from the hour of 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. So to join the conversation, please kindly call or text in your SMSs on the numbers given. So today with me in the studio is Binda Toure, who happens to be my co-presenter for this noble program. And Binda is, of course, a giant when it comes to youth work. So obviously, having her on this platform to be sharing her views together with me will avail many young people the opportunity to know about the challenges, the numerous challenges that the youth sector is confronted with at the moment. And of course, not only the challenges, because you cannot talk about challenges about young people of the Gambia, to be precise. You cannot talk about the challenges that they are facing without talking about the successes that they have registered. Mm-hmm. Young people of the Gambia, actually, they've registered numerous successes. Absolutely. So that has Absolutely. To be acknowledged. As well as the prospects, the opportunities that are in the youth sector. So all these and many other will be discussed. So we have in a text message from we have from the individual. The person said, appreciated to join the program, Hussein Sao. Hussein, thanks a lot for joining the program. So you can send in your SMS on 781-456-329-6069. So thank you very much, Hussein. So if you are just joining us, this is Bolong Dala FM. So Binda?
Uh-huh.
Corruption is a problem.
Indeed.
So Binda, do you think corruption actually affects the youth sector?
Absolutely, yes. It is affecting the young people. So of this thing. I think corruption, Suleiman, corruption is
it's a problem, right? So, tell the listeners how corruption affects the youth sector.
No, you can talk about that now. Come on.
So, thank you, Binda. Anyway, we know corruption, the issue of corruption is across all sectors.
Absolutely.
And in fact, it is not the issue of the Gambia alone. Corruption is an issue for the whole world. It is a concern for the whole world. But underdeveloped countries having high scale corruption is of course sometimes worrying. That is why people will talk about African countries and their corruption. Because that is not because of any other reason. Corruption happens in major countries.
No, I think Africa cannot do away with corruption in general.
Wow.
Because it's like even though individually I can say everyone is corrupt,
mm-hmm.
but we have the percentage of corruption in our life varies. Mm-hmm. But that is why I said, I think you are at a better position to talk about it because you have a wider aspect on that topic. But I will also talk about some other things. Yeah, then you can go on with the corruption as well.
No. Basically, if there is anything that I would add on the issue of corruption, I will say again that corruption is not an issue of the Gambia alone.
Not
corruption is a headache for every country in this globe.
It's more especially African.
Underdeveloped countries or poorly developed countries like African countries, being involved in high scale corruption is what worries and is what actually gets people into deep dialogue when it comes to issues related to corruption. So corruption is a concern for this singular program as well, because I mean we want to see that particular sector of young people in this country who will be, it's like we're having a caller. Alaykum salam. Good afternoon.
Hello,
good afternoon.
Hello, Mr. Powell.
Yes, good afternoon. Who is online, please? I'm fine.
Okay, this is Marcus.
Can you please tone down the volume of your radio a bit? Can you please tone down the volume of your radio a bit? Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Hello? Are you getting me? Oh.
Looking like I wanted to say when you were talking before the caller came in.
Okay.
I think looking at the aspect of unemployment and underemployment
mm-hmm.
is a serious concern for young people in the Gambia. Do we have a caller? It's a serious concern for young people in the Gambia.
So.
Lot of people are employed, but I think that is not employment. We are on they are underemployed.
Okay.
Because being employed and you cannot meet your daily needs of being employed and having you cannot I just don't know how to say it. I think underemployment is something that is seriously affecting young people in the Gambia, and it's an issue that we need to address. Because you being employed every day, going to work, coming back home, the expectation from the family people on you, it's high, and at the end of the day you cannot provide even your own needs. You cannot provide it. I think it's an issue that we need to really discuss, and even government need to take up from there to see the underemployment in the youth sector. And I think young people need to be employed.
Mm-hmm.
There are a lot of young people who are sitting outside, who are sitting out there, and they are not doing anything.
We have in another caller. So
hello,
good afternoon.
Hello?
I am getting you loud and clear. Who is online, please? Whoa.
Wow, we lost that call again. I think everybody it's
hello.
Hello, assalamu
alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.
Good afternoon.
I'm in love with the program. I'm just listening. I'm calling to appreciate the program.
Thank you very much.
Just keep up the hard work. You know, I'm also a youth, so I'm calling that in the camera here.
Thank you very much.
So just keep up the momentum and, you know, thumbs up.
Thank you very much. So would you mind to tell us your name, please?
Wow.
For that motivation, we will consider it a motivation. Thanks a lot. We just here serving as moderators, but basically, you people, that is the listeners, you are far more important than us when it comes to this program, because you cannot talk about young people without by exempting you from that sector. It is from the listeners that we have those young people, although we are also part of young people, but majorly you. From the major, the greater number. So we consider you as very important aspects of this program. So we will be definitely waiting on your calls, your contributions every weekend from the hour of 2 to 3 on this particular radio station. So we are having
a text message.
Mm-hmm. Binda?
All right.
We have
a
caller. Wow, we missed that caller as well.
Okay, we have a text message. Let's go with this one.
Okay.
Hello, wonderful people. I'm listening to the program. It's interesting. Keep inspiring. Lamin Tarawale of Mandina Bar. Thank you very much, Lamin Tarawale. I think you are we are also being inspired by you, because you taking your time texting us to appreciate what we are doing. I think we are in this together. Thank you very much, Lamin Tarawale. Like I was saying, Suleiman, I think the listeners are one of our key stakeholders in this thing.
Indeed.
So their views cannot be neglected. That's why their views cannot be neglected. It's important we listen to what they said, so you can see we can start from there, because this is the first program and we want to generate more ideas on how to go about this program. So they being part of it is very important. Thank you, Lamin Tarawale.
All right, thank you very much, Mr. Lamin Tarawale. A very hard-working youth, I know him. So
indeed,
keep up the momentum and keep following this program. We hoping to get many stakeholders on board for a better youth sector in the Gambia. So okay, we have a text message.
Again?
And this one seems to be very interesting though.
Wow.
The person said, the topic corruption reminds me of having discussion with my colleagues at the UTE campus. The minds are focused on eradicating the corruption, but the idea is the system. The system is bigger than you, and to fight this, people must be engaged in understanding what is corruption from all spheres from life. I think as time goes on, people will go to let go corruption. Yeah, I think as time goes on, people will let go corruption. So thanks a lot.
Yeah,
that was a wonderful contribution. Yeah. I think corruption everybody's is very broad.
Yes, and everybody's opinion on corruption should be respected.
Yeah.
In general, everybody's opinion should be respected, because what happened is you have your own take of everything. So your take and my take will be different sometimes, but we are all working towards the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
And we all working to have a better youth population. Mm-hmm. A youth population that will be engaged.
Mm-hmm.
A youth population that will be engaged from grassroots level up to the national level.
Mm-hmm.
Suleiman, and come to think of it, at the regional level, I think it's high time we hold our leaders accountable.
Okay.
Especially leaders that are working with the young people.
Mm-hmm.
in our own communities.
Mm-hmm.
It's high time we know what they are doing. Yes, most of us are not part of the youth work, or we are not interested in youth work. But I think it's high time we have youth leaders in the Gambia that we need to hold accountable, because it's important. If you look at it, you have youth leaders that you don't even know about. So it's important. Sometimes we will have them on this program to come and talk to us about what they have for us and the way forward for the young people in West Coast.
Exactly. So
let's go with this one. Assalamu alaikum. I'm in love with your program. Keep it up. It's me, Fatoumata Diallo, from Daru.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, Miss Fatma. Thank you very much, Fatoumata Diallo from Daru Hairu. We appreciate your contribution to this program.
So thank you very much, Fatoumata Diallo, for that contribution. This program is here for you, and we believe and hope that you will continue listening in our subsequent editions. So like my dad was saying, accounted for their actions. And of course, we have to respect everyone's view when it comes to corruption. In fact,
absolutely.
Respecting people's expression is a fundamental human right. You have to express,
absolutely,
accept and respect people's view. So that is quite important, Binta. So we need to actually involve our leaders. They need to be definitely accounted for their actions.
Absolutely.
See, we cannot talk about a better youth sector when accountability is quite lacking behind,
most especially among we the youths.
So
I think me, sometimes when I sit and think about the young people in the Gambia, I will see to myself, do we really want to take part in the youth development in the Gambia?
It's a question.
Because what happened is, you have leaders at the regional level.
Mm-hmm.
We have a regional youth committee.
Mm-hmm.
We have a district youth committee.
Yeah.
We have village youth committee.
Yeah, yeah.
So if you don't take part in it, who is going to take part in it?
Yeah.
And we will just be sitting. Most of us young people, we will say, oh, I can't even hear the
so.
It's high time we eradicate that thought.
That's
and, a and stand together to build a better future for the young people. Because if you want to have a better future tomorrow,
mm-hmm,
most especially for the young people and for sustainability purpose,
mm-hmm,
I think it's high time you engage yourself in activities that are related to youth work. At least you will understand better,
mm-hmm,
how you are going and how you are being.
Mm-hmm. No, it's important, Binda. It's very important. In fact, that reminds me, because like, we all come from communities.
Absolutely.
And as a young person, it is a responsibility on you to take part in the development of your communities, most especially when it comes to voluntary services.
Absolutely.
But I mean, how many young people are actually involved?
It's a question.
It's a very big question.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes those that are very active in their respective communities, rendering voluntary activities, voluntary service, sometimes certain individuals don't even value them, but
absolutely,
they don't know that those are actually the movers of the community. Those are the pillars of the community. So how important is it for other young people who are just, let me say, lookers? They only look at
you and you're
around. and keep on judging. What will you say to them to?
I think for me, sometimes that is why I keep talking. But sometimes if you meet me on the way, you think I don't say anything, but I talk. Mm-hmm. I met So Suleiman, I talk to young people about the importance of youth development.
Yeah.
Like I said, there are a lot of people. Do we have a caller over that specific?
No, we don't have a caller.
Like I said, there are young people around who don't even know the value of youth work.
Mm-hmm.
Volunteerism is very important, Suleiman.
Indeed.
There are a lot of people out there who volunteer to become what they are today.
Yeah.
I think being a volunteer does not mean that you are wasting your time.
Indeed.
People are doing so many things together.
Mm-hmm.
I am working,
mm-hmm.
I am volunteering,
mm-hmm.
and I am doing so many things at the same time.
Yeah.
So I think other young people can emulate from others that are doing far, far better than us.
Mm-hmm.
At least because everything needs a stepping stone.
Mm-hmm.
Being part of being a volunteer, it's also going to be an added advantage onto you as that individual.
Mm-hmm.
Because you being a volunteer, you learn from people.
That is
you learn from people who you are working with.
Mm-hmm.
So having that knowledge alone, I think it's something that worth of being a volunteer.
Indeed. You see, volunteerism prepares an individual. When you are volunteering, you learn, you get experience, and that experience stays with you for life, you know. So it is important. So the community has always been a concern for me.
Absolutely.
The attention that young people are paying to their respective communities is draining gradually, even though we have success when you want to grade the overall performance of young people in this country. But at the level of our communities, I mean, we need a thorough attitudinal change when it comes to the issue of young people. Young people are not focusing to a certain extent on some of the things or steps that they should take towards their community. It is a responsibility on every caller on the line, so we can talk to the person. Hello, good
afternoon. Salam.
Hello, salam
alaikum. Wa alaikum salam.
Hey, salam, how good people.
Alhamdulillah, we are fine and you.
Yeah, is it Fatima? I don't know what's the name of the man and the family. You live.
I'm in the LY Ture.
Okay, I'm somewhere in the Amozo. I'm a part of this place.
No. Thank you very much for your service.
I'm so much impressed on the program.
Thank you very much.
Well, you guys are really motivating the young people.
Thank you very much.
I think this will be discussed in any radio station in the Gambia to empower the youth.
Thank you very much.
That is very, very important.
Because we are the leaders tomorrow.
Yeah.
Well, this Uncle Correction is very well in that institution on the work. You get it.
Absolutely.
I mean, we are finding it very difficult to employ in any institution you go to.
Wow, that is very, very.
Do you mean that you are from college or you are from university? When you go to any institution, the elderly person or the babas and other people there.
I think our old banana.
They are giving us a way to be employed.
Absolutely.
I mean, it's hard. Because if you're scared to follow an elder person to be employed by both, why he is treating you in any way, you know.
It's not really easy.
Yeah, I mean, I went to a place where I took my papers, but I said, that day, he treated me. It was a day.
What?
Yeah, I feel scared to go back there. Because this Marabu is the other stuff, so I was a part of corruption, huh?
That's too sad.
There's also this stuff in our country.
That's too sad, indeed.
And you are?
Yeah, well, I am Buwa. I'm from South Abanta.
Buba from Frawabanda.
Yeah, thank you so much.
That's from Kombo. It's my place. Thank you very much, Buba.
Uh-huh.
Well, thank you very much, Buba. Thanks for your contribution. And I think definitely your participation add value, because like you talked about corruption and of course the presence of, let's say, how do we term them?
Old bananas.
Okay, fine. He said he was threatened by one individual. So we come back to Buba. Let's see who is online. Hello, good
afternoon.
Good afternoon,
sir.
Who is this? What's your name and where are you calling us from?
Hello, good afternoon. Wow, we lost him.
All right, we lost that caller.
I think like you do actually see. When old bananas refuse to die, young suckers will not come up. Like Chinua Achebe will say, when old bananas refuse to die for young suckers to come.
Mm-hmm.
I think that is what Wuba is trying to say.
Yeah, indeed.
But
let's
go with this one.
Hello. So in case you are just joining us, please call or text us on 7841456, 7841456, 3296069, 3296069. This is Bolong Dala FM, 91.2, located in Brikama. So this is your weekly youth hour that comes on your way every Saturday from the hours of 2 to 3 p.m. And just be reminded that this is the first edition. So we're trying to gauge the opinions of our listeners about, generally issues related to young people of this country, and specifically how we would be staging this program in our subsequent edition. So call or text and give us your impression as well as your contribution about this program. So Binda, you say when the old bananas...
that is what Buba is trying to say. But I think it's very important for old people to give chances to young people.
Mm-hmm.
Because we are going to be the future leaders of tomorrow. If you don't give us the chance to develop ourselves, I think we are going nowhere.
Mm-hmm.
Because in case you are normal, who are those that will take after you?
Yeah.
I think it's a question that we need to ask ourselves.
Indeed.
Sometimes when you are old and you reach a retirement age, I think it's high time you bring someone close to you that you will be teaching and training the person in case after you that individual can come up. Because I think our development is not a one stop.
It's a multi-dimensional
aspect.
Yeah.
You being there for 60 years or for 40 to 50 years, I think it's enough. It's high time we bring in young people. Okay, let's go with the caller.
Yeah, we're having another caller. Let's see who is online.
Hello.
Hello, assalamu alaikum. Good afternoon.
Yeah,
fine.
Okay, my name is Buakar Yabo.
Buakar Yabo, thank you Bua, for joining us.
Hello.
Welcome to
Hello,
the program.
Okay. Very happy. I'm very interested about your program.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, this is a learning point for the youth.
Indeed.
And see how best they can do for themselves and the country.
Indeed. Thank you very much.
Yeah, I'm very happy about that.
Thank you
very much.
All right, thank you so much.
Thank you, we appreciate your call. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Buba. We appreciate your call and we hope you will be joining us in our subsequent edition. So we have some couple of text messages. Binda?
All right, let me go with it. Oh, okay. Is this one?
Yeah.
This one said really interested in this program because the youth are everything, but I think you should talk about the issue for 30 minutes and 30 minutes for calls. I think that is better. This is the place to listen to. Thank you very much, Mrs. Texa. I think yes, this is our first program. That is why we opened the radio. But in our subsequent program, we will talk for 30 minutes and open the line for 30 minutes so that the audience can join us and talk about their own views. Thank you very much, Mr. Texa. Let's go with this one. Like this?
Yeah.
Okay. This one said, "Assalamu alaikum. Your program is very interesting." And I think I did this one. It's very interesting and inspiring. We need to eradicate. Yeah, we did this one. Let me go with another one. This one said, Hi, guys. How are you?
We are.
How We are listening to your program with
my wife.
Ah, okay. Sorry. Thank you.
There comes a time when we hit a certain call, when the world must come together as one. There are people dying.
Oh, when it's time to lend a hand to life,
the greatest gift of all.
We can't go on pretending day by day
that someone somehow will soon make a change.
We are all a part of
Wife Adosise. Thank you very much, Mister, and your our regards to your wife Adosise. I think.
Okay. End of today's program. So definitely we will be anticipating your participation and contribution, of course, in our subsequent programs. So do remind that it was Balong Dala FM 91.2, and I am your host together with Binda Ture. We'll be coming on your way next week Saturday from the hours of 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. So Binda,
it's already done. Thank you very we cannot do them, maybe till next week we come UV. This is going to be a normal program, a usual program every weekend from 2 to 3 o'clock. So we expecting to hear a lot more from you people. Thank
okay,
you.
Okay, from Binda.
A program designed for students from nursery to senior secondary school will come on the airwaves this Sunday and any other Sunday here on BFM.
To participate, answer at least 3 to 5 questions in our programs and stand the chance of coming to the studio.
Do you have a poem that you want to read or recite?
You can call and recite your beautiful poems.
If you have a song that you want to sing?
You can call, sing or rap live in the program.
And there will be debates?
Yes, debates between and among students.
You can't miss this.
Sundays from 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. on frequency.
91.2.
Purely for students.
Students Hour on BFM.
Sponsoring all that I